Hi everyone, I'm Srishti. I'm currently working as a developer advocate for the Wikimedia Foundation, the organization behind Wikipedia. I have been working here for the last 6 years, and one of my roles is to coordinate our participation in GSoC. Today, I would like to share with you my story of how I got involved in contributing to FOSS projects almost a decade ago, and how it all started with GSoC. I feel so fortunate to continue to be a part of the GSoC ecosystem and to have seen it from all sides as a student, mentor, and organization representative. So back in 2011, I was still figuring out what I did during the first 3 years of college and always thinking why I chose computer science for my bachelor's degree. And then GSoC happened. This is a photo of a bunch of us from university campus. We were trying really hard to get folks excited about contributing to free and open source software development. I went for undergrad in a small city, which is in the western state of Rajasthan in India. It is quite far from where the tech industry is, and getting there from my hometown, where there is no airport, it can feel like taking an international trip. The good thing was that we had an active FOSS club in college. And this is where I first heard about GSoC. At that time, internet penetration was taking off. My home had just got a stable connection. And all of a sudden, I had access to these amazing resources online. And I was learning about all these technical events and programs in which I could participate. So I'm in my final year of college, and I have almost zero experience working with a programming language. All I have done so far is some coding assignments as part of my coursework. And there is no way that company executives will travel to our campus and give us internships or job offers. So this motivated me to apply for GSoC. I wanted to get a chance to work on a real-world project and to gain some skills. I picked an educational software, GCompris, which used to be a part of the GNOME's desktop operating system. And nowadays, it is part of KDE. I found the requirement for this project to be easy. It was asking for a beginner-level Python skills. So I wrote a proposal around developing educational activities to introduce children in the age group 2 to 10 to the Braille language. I was not trying to keep my hopes any high with the amount of technical skills I had then. I still remember that it was midnight in India when the results came in. And I was waking everyone in the family to share that I got accepted into this very cool program and I would get paid for it. GSoC was an out of the world experience. The opportunity to code and ship it to a real project gave me this immense confidence to learn and build new things. So this kid who did not even know how to use technology appropriately was on to developing apps that thousands of people would use. I completed GSoC and undergrad, and after that, I took a software job at an edtech startup. But because GNOME was such a friendly and welcoming community, I wanted to understand it more and keep contributing to some of the community outreach-related activities of the GNOME community. Sometimes I would run technical workshops around using UI frameworks, give talks about GCompris, and mentor newbies on contributing to the project. What I loved about doing GSoC was that it allowed me to wear multiple hats while working on the project, from coming up with an idea for the activity to designing the workflow and graphics, writing code, and testing them out with school kids in my neighborhood. It not only kindled in me a deep love for developing edtech tools, but also left me wondering that where in the world I would get the same autonomy and freedom to work in this area at the intersection of multiple skill sets and disciplines. And this led me to join a research group at the MIT Media Lab, which is part of MIT University and that focuses on building educational technologies. So this kid who could not make it to the top tech schools in India, that is the IITs, was now accidentally in one of the top engineering schools in the world. And I think that the contributions to the open source project I made through GSoC And this interest in exploring FOSS in education that the program helped me discover played a huge role. I met many people at the lab with similar stories who had also done GSoC. Some even ended up in academia, and they now teach in universities offering higher education. I spent 3 years at the lab in online learning research, specifically developing a free and open source tool called UnHangout to foster large-scale participant-driven events online. This tool is even used today for professional development by educators and university professors. They even use it in their MOOC courses on various platforms such as MITx, edX, and so on. Fast forward 5 years, I finished grad school, and I now feel this privilege to choose an organization whose values align with my own, that does FOSS development in the education sphere, and where I could take on a role to be this person who wears multiple hats. So from grad school, I landed at Wikimedia as the developer advocate, where I now develop and organize learning and knowledge sharing initiatives for the technical community behind Wikipedia and its sister projects. It brought me so much joy to connect with former colleagues from the open source world at Wikimedia and to join an organization I could call home for a few years. When I did GSoC, I was the first female and only one from my batch to get into the program that year. I met a college junior recently in Silicon Valley in the US, where I'm now based. This fellow is 6 years junior to me, and I've probably never overlapped with him in college. I laughed and felt a bit shy when he told me that my college professors would show my photo on their curriculum slides to inspire others. And since then, many people from my university, they have done GSoC, and it's just amazing to see the network effect that this program created. So this was my story. And now, based on my learnings from being involved in GSoC in various roles, I have 3 tips to share with future contributors to make the most out of their GSoC experience. The first thing is to ensure that your code lands in a public repository of the organization, get deployed, and becomes part of something impactful and widely used. When you are doing GSoC, there is a lot of work to do, and you're not thinking about these things and how they will add to your portfolio. When I look back, I remember that when I was applying for grad schools and jobs, I was able to provide links to my contributions and show project documentation and demo videos of the educational activities that I had developed. And it all turned out to be super helpful. Also, make sure that you write good quality code, because sometimes interviewers might decide whether or not they want you based on a previous code that you have written. And the second, the GSoC experience can be intense and overwhelming, and the internship period, it flies by quickly. But if you have some bandwidth, try to understand the community and look for opportunities for all kinds of contributions other than code beyond your own project. Open source projects and initiatives, they thrive because of their volunteer community. When you're done with your GSoC project, you could also help out in other ways. For example, you can become a mentor in the following round, do bug triaging, offer maintenance help, or conduct outreach, maybe in your university or professional circle, to help bring new people. And this engagement can also help you understand where your interest lies and what skills you're most comfortable with that can help you advance in your career. And finally, the third. So most of my learning happened through deep and long-lasting connections in open source communities, in local and global face-to-face events. You can find out if your community has a local group and if they meet regularly. Most large open source communities, they have a global presence, and they run events to meet often. Smaller communities, they participate in external FOSS events. So you can learn about ways to obtain scholarships to attend such events and get a chance to meet with your community members and to collaborate with them in real time. But if face-to-face is not an option, you could still look into the venues where your community is most active. I want to say thank you to the entire crew of Google Open Source team for this amazing program and for continuing to run it for years and bringing an impactful change in the lives of people with diverse backgrounds from all over the world. Thank you.